What is going on, guys? It's the Scorpion HD here, back again with another video. Right now you're probably wondering, you know, what the hell's going on here? Why am I covering Destiny again? And considering all the, you know, stuff I've said about this game in the past, why you know, have I even thought to upload a video on it? Well, you might have guessed, the predictables happened, really. I saw this game going on the PS Store for around, I think it was £25, around 2 weeks ago now. And I decided, I don't know, I just kind of wanted a real grindy game that would last me quite a while, so I decided to purchase it, go ahead and download it. And I must say, so far actually, this has been quite a surprise for me. Obviously, I've said in the past, you know, this game didn't live up to half of the, you know, hype. But that's the case for most games right now. It's not a bad game, not at all. It is not for everyone, but, you know, I've been pretty much obsessed with it for the past 2 weeks. Like, it's all I play. And due to the clever way that they've made it in terms of things like daily caps and weekly caps on the amount of reputation and currency you can earn, there's a lot of longevity there if you're, you know, determined enough to keep playing it. It does strike me as something, you know, I've heard a lot of people talk about it. People keep coming back to play it, and I don't think you'd have understood that unless you actually play the game. You know, it really does have that kind of feeling to it, that it's something that you're going to play an awful lot and keep coming back to. So in the past 2 weeks of playing, I've got level 30 Warlock and level 25 Hunter already. So I have had some help in that. The Warlock, I pretty much ran through all of the missions and, you know, just the standard stuff, because I had a friend that was level 28 at that time. But the Hunter has, you know, been mainly my own doing, besides some help here and there whenever I've been too low level to complete missions and stuff. And I'm really enjoying it so far, you know. It is the kind of game I feel like I needed. Don't get me wrong, the campaign in this game is almost non-existent. Like, that's not the good part of it. That's definitely not the good part of it. For me, what makes this game so great is like, I'm the kind of person that, you know, wants to get the best armor, get all that, and in this game, after level 20, if you don't know, your armor affects your rank, so you're going to want to try and get the best armors. The way that you get these armors and stuff like that to rank up and better guns and stuff is you can buy them from Xur, which I know a lot of you will know about. I even knew about Xur. Thought that was a pretty cool feature whenever I didn't even have the game, you know. I used to hear on Twitter, like, what has Xur brought this week, and it would kind of intrigue me. But yeah, the way they've done it is, the way you can get this gear is mainly by doing raids, which are six-man missions. This isn't one of them that you're seeing here. This is just a strike. I believe this was a nightfall for this week, which, yeah, the weekly nightfall this week's pretty hard, I'm not going to lie. It's the Omnigul battle, which you need Dark Below for, obviously. Talking about expansions, I have got the Dark Below and House of Wolves is coming out next week, so that'll be good. The amount of features that looks to add will be pretty insane. For me, this game is mostly about PvE, if I'm honest. I don't mind the PvP, but that's mainly because I'm shit at it. I've kind of established that after playing a few hours worth of it. I prefer to play the PvE stuff, you know, the raids, the strikes, the nightfalls, the weekly heroic, daily heroic, all that kind of stuff. Yeah, as I was saying, the way you get these armors is to, you know, play these strikes, nightfalls, and raids. But you can only play them once a week and get rewarded for it. So basically, if you play them all in a day, then you can keep playing them after and you'll get experience and stuff, but you're not going to get the armor or the possibility of a new, you know, exotic rifle or something. So you'll have to wait for the next week, and that as I was saying, I think that's why so many people still play this game. You know, it's the kind of thing you do need to put a lot of time into. Maybe not, you know, playing it all week every day, although I can understand if you do enjoy that. But, you know, the weekly reset where the, you know, the amount of currency you've earned and stuff, the Vanguard marks and stuff like that, and, you know, the weekly reset for the raids and the gear you can earn takes place on a Tuesday. This is the kind of game that I feel you would be playing. You'd go back to it every Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday to get those raids, your Vault of Glass, your Crotus End done, and then, you know, keep doing that every week. That's what most of the hardcore Destiny players have done, and that's why I feel for the price I paid anyway, 25 quid, this game, it's really been good value for money in my opinion. I've played it for a good 30 hours probably already. Like, I'm supposed to be off on study leave at the minute for exams, and you know, I am revising and stuff obviously. I do around 6 hours of revision a day, but other than that, I've just been playing Destiny flat out. So yeah, it has been a big surprise for me, this game. Don't get me wrong, the campaign is non-existent, it is shit. That's not why you want to play this game. Also, another problem with it might be not having any friends that play it. I have a few. But if that is the case, you can post on the Destiny forums for other people, you know, to join your party and stuff. You can make friends that way. We've certainly done that. For example, for the raids, we've had to post on forums to get, you know, 3 extra people or whatever, because we don't have 6 friends that all play Destiny, or are online at that time. But yeah, as I said, you know, a big surprise to me. I definitely think I'll be doing more coverage on this game in the future. Not really sure what on, probably something on the House of Wolves, but as far as, you know, proper devoted coverage to this game, all the YouTubers that have, you know, done that, they're kind of established by now. You know, on their weekly, what is Zur brought, stuff like that. I don't know, I might do videos like that. We'll have to wait and see, but we'll see how well this video goes down. But yeah, guys, just wanted to make a video like this to let you know what I was doing, what I've been playing recently, and if you've been considering at all picking up Destiny, would encourage it. It's a different kind of game. It's gonna keep you playing it, but you have to be determined. And yeah, I definitely feel like I'll be playing this game for quite a long time, with the expansions to come in the future as well. Yeah, guys, thanks for watching, and yeah, cheers.